So this week we received an extraordinary new design from Giulia Bassan and Alessandro Benedetti, young Italian designers who are making a name for themselves in the expedition market. This is a 260 foot, 80 meter conversion design to take a commercial offshore supply vessel, either an Ulstein or an American built hull, and convert it into a global expedition yacht.
I usually focus on a vessel's capabilities. I'd like to take a moment here to share with you images of the design from Bassan and Benedetti on the use of the deck space. Each of the decks, whether they are salons or they are guest suites or the owner's deck, they all open up onto vast, well thought out exterior spaces. Each deck is completely different in terms of form and function. And the interiors have got high ceilings. They've got large glass showing where you're going and where you've been, and they are nice and bright and completely modern. Remember that all of these interior spaces are new. They are built on top of the aft deck. And as such, all of these spaces would be newly designed, custom designed to reflect the taste of the new owner. And the fabrication would be going on at a facility someplace else in the world other than where the ship's being converted. And then later they would be married together.
Immediately you can see that this design has got a lot of style and a lot of excellent lines. However, what I really like about the way that they work is that they keep the bridge and the superstructure, which is the core of the commercial vessel. All the steelwork, all the crew quarters, the galley, the crew mess, everything is intact within this new modular wrapper, which is clearly a yacht. I really like what they did with this 3D graphic that illustrates the conversion process in terms of what they're doing to the actual vessel. They're removing the commercial steel and machinery off of the deck to give a clear building space on the aft deck, taking off the old stack, taking off some of the deck house, and then these sections are effectively modules that are dropped in. The main accommodation block right here can actually be built in a shed away from the vessel while the rest of the conversion work's going on, like removing the mud tanks and the unneeded tanks in the hull and hydraulics. They also keep the main powertrain and the main power systems underneath the main deck in the hull. And so that retains the value of the initial commercial vessel. And that's the key to a smart conversion. Well, even though they have a helideck aft, it's raised up, and they still have a wonderful seating area back here with great ocean access. And using overhead I-beam lifts, you've got a tender and toy garage here that is probably a 10 meter or so tender, and a wonderful on-deck swimming pool and sunning area. Great use of space. This would be the alternative if you didn't have a helipad aft. You could have more tenders, more toys. You could have a submersible launch system here, whether it be an A-frame or some kind of a rail situation to get a submersible in and out of the water. Overall, there's a great deal of interior space. We're going to look at that shortly. But look at all this deck area. It maximizes the open space that you get on these OSVs while still delivering a lot of gross tonnage and interior. So this is a typical 260 foot offshore supply vessel. This one is US built with Caterpillar equipment. It's got Ulstein and Rolls-Royce azipods and dynamic positioning equipment, including a drop down azipod in the bow. What's nice about this 80 meter design is that we can marry it to an existing offshore supply vessel, a commercial ship, that has all the crew quarters. In this case, the engine room is all the way aft where the azipods are, and that means that the noise and vibration of the engine room is not up in here as it normally is in a white yacht. It's isolated. It has tremendous fuel capacity, over 200,000 gallons of fuel. So this vessel, as it sits, will have a 14,000 nautical mile range or more. So these are ocean-proven hulls that's part of the key to this whole process. You're not going to spend a year or 2 years on the basic hull design and getting the engineering done and the class approvals before you start to cut steel. We can go right into conversion with one of these hulls with what is already an ocean-going, ready-to-go-to-sea vessel.
Check the links below for further information on this conversion project. And by all means, if you'd like to leave comments, we'd love to see them.